Chris Kreider. Wow. Proven producer over the great speed.
Chris Kreider!
Skjei is an exquisite skater. The way he's been able to move.
Skjei fires and scores!
Kreider, just spectacular play.
He's been an absolute beast.
Here comes Kreider.
What a shot.
Oh, what a play! Skjei! Brady Skjei does it again!
Chris Kreider and Brady Skjei will be boarding a flight tomorrow, but before they do so, they've made some time to stop by with us. Guys, thanks for coming
in.
We appreciate it.
Thanks for having us. Yeah, thank you for having
How long is the flight?
That's a good question.
6 hours, I think. Do you guys do well on long flights or no?
Yeah, I feel like...
You might, I don't.
Okay.
Are you guys all meeting over there, or is everybody coming from their own location, or coming here and then flying over?
Yeah, we're meeting here at Newark and then flying over at 7:30 tomorrow.
Long trip.
So you love guys to play cards with and stuff.
Perfect. Yeah.
I can't sit that long. I don't know. Long flights weird me out. I don't like them. It's going to be a great time. Why do you guys want to play in the tournament? I mean, not everybody goes, but what excites you about it?
Well, I saw the roster and I saw the team they're putting together. Obviously,
it's a good answer.
Yeah. Chris Drury and all the other managers did a great job. And when you see that many talented players going over and representing your country, it's usually a good sign.
Chris, you've had a number of opportunities to do this now. I mean, it is probably an exciting time, something different to do, and you get to wear the colors of the United States.
Yeah, obviously it's a huge honor. It's a really fun tournament. Get to see parts of the world you've never seen before, and the competition is pretty elite.
What's the fun part? What's the best thing you've seen in some of these trips you've been on that you would have never maybe not have been able to see? A museum or something special?
Yeah, well, actually, when I was 19, went to Košice and went to a steel mill, I think it was. And so that was definitely not something I would have done myself.
Really?
So.
Yeah.
Nice.
We talked with Coach Blasio yesterday. Was it yesterday?
The days were running.
Yes. Thank you very much. Yes. He can't wait. He loves the roster too. He loves what's going. We asked him just about how you guys have gotten. You guys, mean the U.S., more and more used to the international play. I know you did it as youngsters too, more and more. But how long do you think that transition will take, especially from the North American, the NHL ice to the bigger ice? How long does it take you guys to get used to that?
I don't think that long. I feel like a practice or two, and then maybe first period of the first game, you can kind of get back into it. And like you said, there's a ton of guys that have played in the international before, and once you get the feel of that big ice, it's usually a pretty smooth transition.
Well, aside from the ice, obviously, it's a short tournament, and you guys are all playing together for the first time. Does it take a long time to sort of find your chemistry with each other, or have you all been playing hockey so long that it doesn't really matter as long as you're playing the systems right?
Yeah, well, I think you were commenting today on it, right? There's a lot of national team guys, a lot of BC Eagles, too.
Okay.
So it's such a small hockey world at this point, so everyone kind of knows each other. And that's something that I think we kind of sort out within the first 4 days or so.
Hey, Brady, I'll ask you, because you mentioned the roster, who are you looking forward to having on your team?
There's a ton of guys. Yeah. Obviously, I feel like I play with most of the guys on the team, but haven't had a chance to play with Patrick Kane yet. So
yeah, that's a good one, right?
Really excited to play with him. Got to know him a little bit, or I've met him a few times, so to play with him is going to be a lot of fun.
What about guys on other teams? Is there a world... championship trash talking at all that you guys have started yet, or are we not there just yet?
Well, I shot on Henrik Lundqvist for the past week and a half or so. And it was just me and him out there, so yeah, there was a little bit of trash talk. But
what were your sessions like with him? What was that like? How long would you stay out there and shoot on him?
As long as he wanted pucks, and he likes seeing shots. So I scored a handful of goals.
Nice. All right.
You're not gonna lie. Spotted a few.
Hopefully you saved a few for the game against them. I want to ask you about Henrik Lundqvist and what he was like this year, because this is a proud veteran player, a player that had been through a ton, a lot of winning. And this was at times an up and down year for you with the New York Rangers as you guys retool. And say, how was he? He's such an intense guy. We know we see the fire. How was it to watch him, this season?
He had his ups and downs, but I think it's unbelievable how competitive he is and how focused he is every single day. He comes to the rink, he's always usually the last guy off the ice taking shootouts or before games, so focused. And to be able to see that every day and to be able to learn off that, it's really huge.
Hey, I want to ask you guys if you've been watching
the playoffs. You have to be watching because it's crazy. Very predictable, right? Just like you thought. Tampa's moved on pretty quickly, right?
Yeah, it's your bracket.
How crazy is it to you guys who play in the league and are dealing with this night after night with all these teams?
Yeah, I mean, it's pretty entertaining for us, too. It obviously hasn't stacked up the way everyone thought it was going to. I mean, something else we were talking about, I think, earlier today was, you know, some of these teams that were playing meaningful games down the stretch, you know, 8 or 10 games left and they weren't in. They're playing really good games for the first couple of rounds. So I think that's the exciting part about hockey, right? Very unpredictable.
So you think that momentum carries over when a team sort of has to fight down the stretch for their spot?
Definitely.
Okay.
Yeah, I mean, you guys in Columbus were battling on that last Friday of the season. I mean, you could have knocked them right out.
Yeah, I know.
And now here they are in the second round. It's
been crazy,
right?
To watch, yeah.
The league is, like, I always stand here every day and I say, listen, the league is so close. You guys playing it. I mean.
Yeah, every single team can win it any night. It really is. It's that close, and these playoffs are showing that. And obviously playoff hockey is that much more intense. And right now, I mean, I think any team could win it.
Yeah. Are you guys hockey junkies? Some guys watch everything. Some guys don't watch that much.
Yeah.
What are you guys like when it comes to watching hockey?
I'm watching a lot of the Eastern Conference games. Those Western Conference games are on a little
bit late.
They're
tough. Oh, my gosh.
Those are tough.
Well, you're a Minnesota guy. You can stay up a little later.
Yeah, I can stay up an hour later.
There you go. There you go. I like it.
You got the one hour.
Hey,
first period.
Are you watching your boy Matt Zuccarello?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
I mean, he's doing
He's killing it.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, he is. He's been texting him here and there, and we want them to keep going.
There's the business side of the game.
I'm a big Stars fan right now.
How about the draft lottery? Did you guys watch that, or did you just kind of read about it the next day?
I just got a text. A text from people, you know, pretty surprised that we got the second overall pick. But I mean, obviously, when you can add up. The top five pick to your lineup, someone who can contribute right away. I mean, that's a huge get for us.
What's the rest of your guys' summer like after you come back from the World Championships? Anything fun planned for either of you before you get back to the grind of training?
A few golf trips.
Shocking.
I think my
I like that.
Never heard an athlete say that before.
Yeah. I'm gonna head to Colorado for a weekend. That's all I have planned. Just gonna go back to Minnesota and train and play in the beauty league.
Brian Lawton again.
Yep, that's right.
That's right. What about you?
Yeah, I don't have much planned. I'm not really a golfer, so try to get outside, get a little bit of sun, get back to work.
What do you do for fun then? If you don't like golfing, what do you do in your off time?
Wiffle ball.
You were the right place.
Did we get footage of that?
I don't know.
Hashtag fail, you guys.
We might. You never know.
We might have some.
He also has a great event. Go ahead. He also has a great event with his uncle and his family in Andover, Mass, for epilepsy, for supporting epilepsy.
Yeah, they run kind of like a mini one-day camp to raise money towards epilepsy. My cousin suffers from epilepsy. Your daughter, obviously, has the same thing going on. So it was the first time that they actually organized it last summer. Went really well, and hoping to build off that going forward.
Great.
Try to get Brady off the golf course and out of Minnesota so he can help out.
There you go. I'll be there. Looks like a nice fella.
I think he'll be there.
I think he'll do it.
Listen, you guys, it's been a blast having you guys here. Enjoy the long flight over, and good luck over there.
Yeah, good luck. When you come back with the gold medal, just stop by, and we can rehash the whole thing.
Perfect.
Because all the games will be right here on the NHL Network, so perfect.
Sounds like a plan.
All right.
Now, you've agreed to it on camera.
Yeah.
So they're going to hold it against you and let your PR guys know. They said they would do it.